Okay, so it's Saturday morning, 9 o'clock, and I'm going to be doing some stuff to the 36 today. Probably going to be re-tinting the windows, because I've done them yesterday and the day before. First one came out pretty good. And then the rear ones, as you can see, were not good at all. So, yeah, it was my first time doing it. So I'm not that annoyed. You know, I paid about, I think, like, 10 quid for 6 metres by 76 centimetres, so I've got loads of this stuff anyway. So yeah, I'm just gonna have to redo it again. So yeah, we're taking these rear pop outs out. It's pretty simple. You just have a torx screw in there, and then you have a 10mm nut about here and one down about there. So like I said, there's a 10mm in here, a 10mm in here. Well, I actually only have a 10mm here because yesterday when I was putting it back in, I managed to drop one of the nuts down. It's gone all the way down to the bottom of the car. So I'm probably gonna have to go like magnet fishing for that later. Anyway. So yeah, I'm gonna be a lot careful at taking this one out. Because I don't fancy losing another one. Bam, boom, got it. Put that somewhere safe. Right, okay, bam. Cool, so I did take a video of me getting the actual boom window out, but my camera ran out of memory, so it's cut it off, and to be honest, it's quite a pain in the ass, so I can't really be bothered to film it, so you're just going to have to use your imaginations for that one. Anyway, let's get to sorting this out. Right, so, welcome to my shed. It's a bit of a mess, quite frankly. Me and my brother and a couple mates, we cleared it all up a while ago. Loads of bags and rubbish, loads of stuff to go to the tip, but obviously with what's going on in the world, the tip is now not open, so we can't throw it away, so I'm going to have to live with this mess. Right, so, first of all, I'm going to have to peel my old tin off. I don't know how easy this comes off of. Pretty easy, to be fair. Cool, so as you can see, there is a lot of like glue residue on this window. So I've got some Oblit RA and a shitty old rag. So yeah. Oh, fuck me, put a load on there, fuck it. Right, so, I didn't do this last time, but I decided, as it's a 26-year-old car, there's probably a lot of stuff on the inside of the windows, which will affect putting down the tint. So, what I'm going to do is actually going to clay the inside of the windows and see how that comes out as well. I mean, I imagine that most of that vinyl that was previously on it has probably taken it off anyway, any sort of dirt and grime that was on it. I did clean these before I put that first one on, but, yeah. There's a bit of black and grit coming off of it, so that was cool. Right, so let's get to putting some tint on it. So this is the window tint I bought. It was like £10 for a roll. It's 6 meters by 76 centimeters, so you know it's given me quite a lot of it. And then also what I did is I bought this pretty good kit. It was only about £8 off eBay. It's got pretty much, you know, everything, squeegee things, a knife. Yeah, and then the only thing, you just want some scissors as well, obviously, just to cut it to shape, to the rough size. So I'm just going to lay out enough to cover it. Luckily, it's sort of the 76 centimeter width actually does cover my rear window, like my back side window is enough. So I pull that much off and cut it. Obviously, it's good just to give yourself a little bit of extra to work with. Sweet as, right, now I've got the bit cut aside. Obviously when I grab some water as well, because you want to spray that on the window and spray that also on the tin. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to give it another little wipe off quick to get rid of any dust. Sweet as, right, just peel the corner off, and then I'm going to cover this in water. Then I'm going to peel that. tint off, let it not stick to me. Then also just cover that in water as well. Lay it on there. That's the good thing about water, is it helps it peel off again when you need to move it about. So now that's roughly on there, just going to grab my squeegee and then just slowly start working all the water and air bubbles out. Cool, so now where I've got it sort of roughly where I want it, most of the air bubbles out, I'm just going to go around and trim all the edges because it helps get rid of some of the air bubbles when you haven't got so much film on there. Throw that off over there. And then just start chasing all those air bubbles and that out of it. Right, sweet as. Pretty much done with it on that. I've only got one sort of air bubble in it, sort of over here. It's kind of just the tint's folded over a bit, so I don't know. I might have to try and sort of cut it out of a blade. But the rest of it has come out pretty sweet, so I'm pretty happy with that. You know, I'm not a professional. You know, I'm doing this in my bloody shed, so, you know, it ain't going to be perfect. So, boom, that's done. Now I get to move on to doing the back window, which is a lot harder. Hopefully it'll be a bit easier this time, because where I've already got the tint cut from the first time I've done it, I can now pull that out and roughly just cut the tint to shape so it can go in there a bit easier. But, you know, we'll see, won't we? Right, so you now join me in the cramped conditions of the back of my car. So it's kind of hard to film in here because there's not really much room having both bucket seats as well. So we're just gonna have to do with what we can do with. I'm gonna take the tint out of this window. Hopefully I can get it all out in one piece, so I can at least try and cut it to a similar shape to make it easy to get back in. Fucking peel it, I guess. Well, oh fuck me. Oh, that is a horrible noise. Alright, sick as, that came out in one piece. Didn't expect it to do that. Right, so what I'm going to do now, take it outside the car, get some film, cut it to shape, bring it back in, clean the window up, and try and stick this fucker back together. Cool, right, so I have cut the new film to shape. It's going to be the same situation as... It's going to be the same situation as... Fuck it. Right, so I've cut the new film. It's going to be the same situation as earlier, where I need to clean all of this window again. So you guys don't really need to see that, so... It's not going to be in the video. If you were hoping to see me clean the back window, I don't know, message me and I might send you a video of me cleaning the back window. Oh, fuck me, where's the bottle? Oh, there it is. I've cleaned the window, clayed it a bit. It did come out quite dirty, actually, funny enough. So what I'm going to do is now cover the whole window in water, pull the film off the tint, cover that in water because it's quite dusty in the back of here. I probably should have hoovered in here or something, but I'm not and I haven't. So cool. So what I've just done is fucked up quite a bit, quite frankly. The bit I cut was, I probably should have added a bit more extra onto there for that bit I was cutting, because it was kind of being a pain in the ass. So you kind of just missed out like a major freak out. I just had a ripping it all off and fucking yeeting it out the window. I've just gone and cut another bit, and I've now gone and cut this too short. And what I've got left over is actually not enough to have a full size thing. But not to worry, because I think this might actually work out better. So what I'm going to do is I've got enough to make two halves. So I'm going to fucking go down the middle of the window like that, do one side, and then get another bit and cut it and get it to fit the other side. So hopefully
that will work. I don't know. Could look shit. But like I say, it only cost me £8. If it's that bad, I'll just order some more. When I was driving with it yesterday, and I actually could not see anything out the back at all, so I was almost sure, kind of thinking I might actually get a bit of a lighter tint for the rear, just because I kind of like seeing out the back in case there's, like, you know, people behind me. And reversing, parking in this is horrible. Welded diff, really bad mirrors, sitting really low in the car. Yeah, most of the time when I reverse park, I have to open the door to look out, which kind of looks a bit shit, and the door's really stiff on this, so I have to sort of shoulder barge it open. Anyway, right, so let's have attempt number 4 and see how we get on with this. So I'm just going to wipe off any stuff that's on it and then spray it with a load of water again. The wind is sort of picking up now, so there's a bit of wind blowing through the car. I've closed one of the doors, but I've got a door open here, which actually I might as well close, but yeah, boom. I've still got a window not in here, so we will see how that goes. Right. Honestly, fucking clapping for the NHS. This window tinting stuff's hard. We should be fucking clapping for window tinters. Honestly, I do not envy their bloody job. Right, well, I've got the second bit in. There's a few little air bubbles in it. I'm not too overly fast. I haven't quite cut it straight down the middle, but, you know, it's not too bad. It'll do for now. I might, you know, get someone else to do it. I don't know. Because I said about the lighter tint. Yeah, there's a few outside, you know, fuck it. Yeah, there's a few air bubbles in it. Let's we'll take a look on the outside of it. Cool, yeah, so this is what it looks like on the outside. You know, there's a few air bubbles. Well, this bit over here you can see. There's a few bits, but you can always cover it up with stickers. I'm kind of hoping that Option Drift are going to do a bigger version of this Good Times one, because that would cover the back of that quite nicely. So, got the window back in now, it's all done. It's not perfect, but you know, it's not a show car, it is a drift car, so I'm not too worried about it all. Can always redo it again at another point. So yeah, that's it. Thanks for watching, guys. Like and subscribe if you want, or don't. Anyway, thank you.